So as I mentioned in the very beginning of this lecture, the cerebellar cortex has about 50% of your entire brain's neurons. We couldn't put them all in this illustration, but they're here in what's called the granule cell layer. So the cerebellar cortex basically has three layers. There's an outer molecular layer. There's kind of an intermediate Purkinje cell layer. And there's this inner granule cell layer. And this is where the cells are really, really dense. Tons and tons of cells. The molecular layer doesn't have a lot of neurons in it. It has some, but not very many. It mostly has the dendritic arbor, all of these dendrites that are extending from this giant Purkinje cell. And here's another one. And here's another one. Then, of course, they live in the Purkinje cell layer. The Purkinje cells are amazing. They extend this huge dendritic arbor, but what's fascinating about it is that it's all in one plane. So it's not it's only two-dimensional. It's not three-dimensional like most dendritic arbors. It is one-dimensional. And these Purkinje cells all throughout the Purkinje cell layer are going to have different orientations of their dendritic arbors. That difference in dendritic arbor orientation is going to determine which of these granule cells pictured here is going to synapse with it. So you can see these granule cells send an axon up into the molecular layer, and then it goes along the edge here and synapses on the Purkinje neurons. The cerebellar cortex gets information, as we talked about, from the brainstem and from the spinal cord and areas of the brainstem concerning balance, and areas of the spinal cord that have to do with the position of your muscles in space. All of this information comes into the cortex via the middle and inferior peduncles. And some of the fibers are going to synapse directly on the Purkinje cells, and some are going to synapse on these granule cells that will then synapse on the Purkinje's. The Purkinje cells then take all of this information and they send it back out down to the deep gray matter of the cerebellum. So information is coming into the cerebellum, going up to the cortex, up to a Purkinje cell, and then back down through the cerebellar white matter to synapse in one of these deep cerebellar nuclei. In this particular section, let me clear the drawing, you can see the dentate. This is the dentate nucleus of the cerebellum. The dentate nucleus and the other deep nuclei of the cerebellum are the part of the cerebellum that then sends information out to the motor cortex via the superior peduncle. So information in through the middle and inferiors, going through some complex circuitry up in the cerebellar cortex, output of the cortex to the deep cerebellar nuclei, and from the deep cerebellar nuclei back out to the motor cortex. And that is how the cerebellum can keep tabs on your spinal cord and your brainstem, and then inform your motor cortex about how what you're doing is actually matching up what you think you're doing or you think you want to do. So in summary, what I want you to know about the cerebellum is I want you to be able to describe its gross anatomy. So think about how many hemispheres and lobes and other named areas. What are the cerebellar peduncles? How many cerebellar peduncles are there? What are their names? What kind of fibers travel in each one of the cerebellar peduncles? When it comes to the cerebellar cortex, how many layers? What are their names? And why are they named differently? So what's going on in each layer? And then when it comes to the cerebellum talking back to the rest of the nervous system, how does this information leave? What's the last stop in the cerebellar train before it goes out? And then how does it get out? If you know all of those kinds of things, then you're ready for the assessment.